Hi, this is Miguel Gomez, the director of AIDS.gov. I'm talking today with Dr. Deborah Persaud at CROI 2013. Dr. Persaud presented earlier this week on findings on a functional HIV cure for an infant in early treatment. That translated to global headlines that Toddler was cured of HIV infection. Ma'am, could you explain the facts and what you presented?
So at this conference, we presented the first, we believe, well-documented case of HIV cure in a 2.5-year-old child. The child was born in Mississippi and was cared for by a pediatric HIV care specialist, Dr. Hannigay, who started antiretroviral therapy, that is three drugs that are standardly used to treat infection in infants. She started those drugs within 2 days of life, so at around 31 hours of age. Mm-hmm. We believe by starting therapy this early resulted in the virus, HIV, not being able to lay down the so-called viral reservoirs. That is, the sleeper cells or the viral hideouts where HIV persists, such that the drugs that we use now to treat infection cannot kill those cells. When we say functional cure, the reason we're saying this baby is functionally cured of HIV is that the baby was, the antiretroviral drugs were stopped, and even with stopping the drugs, the virus did not come back. Mm-hmm. It didn't, could not, no longer be detectable in the blood using standard viral load assays. And even on repeated measurements for up to 10 months off the antiretroviral drugs, the virus did not come back. So we would caution parents and care providers to please not discontinue drugs in their patients. We still have a lot to learn as to what happened in this case. It's just a hypothesis that very early therapy led to cure in these infants. We certainly need to do additional studies and clinical trials to confirm that this can be replicated, and that's our important next step. We're very delighted that the baby and excited that the baby has what appears to have cleared most of the virus or any replicating virus within the child system. And this is, for us, a breakthrough for the field of pediatric HIV infection and gives us a pathway towards cure of this infection. I mean, obviously, if we are able to replicate this, this has very important implications for the hundreds and thousands of kids who are currently born with HIV infection worldwide.
You talked about what it means for infants. Could you share what this knowledge means for adults?
So obviously, the differences between infants and adults with respect to the immune system and why this outcome may be a unique outcome to infants. And that is, the infection is established, or infants are exposed to HIV at a time when they do not have immunologic memory. So that means they don't have memory T cells, or memory T cells may form slower in these infants. We actually don't quite know that, but we know for sure that babies are born mostly with what are called naive cells. That is, cells that have not been exposed to infectious agents. And so one possibility is that this could be a distinct outcome unique to pediatrics. But there are actually some very encouraging data presented at this meeting at CROI by Dr. Jintanat Aranovich from Thailand, showing that indeed if you treat adults very early, and I think the data she presented was a 2-week time frame, this reservoir where HIV persists and hide out, these reservoirs can actually be restricted to the point that this may have important implications or similar implications for adults. But again, more studies need to be done. And again, I want to remind everyone, this is a single case, and it's not clear what other factors contributed to this child being so-called cured of HIV infection.
Well, and thank you for that explanation, because you put it in perspective that it is good news, but it's unique, and that we need to learn more. I really want to thank you for your time. This is Miguel Gomez from the CROI Conference in Atlanta, Georgia. Thank you.